strength and flexibility of a modern carrier air wing. These exercises form the building blocks of integrated and coordinated strike warfare. All the maneuvers you are about to see represent current combat tactics, and the ordnance that will be delivered is part of the annual allowance assigned to each squadron for training. This type of training is an essential element of our combat readiness, in that it constantly tests our ability to load, arm, carry, and deliver combat ordnance on target. USS Saratoga and Carrier Air Wing 17 are comprised of highly trained and dedicated men. Each one plays an important role in the overall effectiveness of the team. With this demonstration, we hope to impress upon you just how effective we are. An SH-3 helicopter from HS-3 is placing a series of smoke flares in the water, abeam the ship. This will provide a simulated target for viewing the performance capabilities and striking power of our carrier-based aircraft. Approaching the stern is an F-14 Tomcat in the landing configuration. Its gear and flaps are extended and its tail hook is down. Please note the variable sweep wings are fully spread to slow speed position. The F-14's approach speed for a carrier landing is 125 knots, about 143 miles per hour. While all-weather day and night carrier landings require relatively slow speeds, this aircraft has the ability to intercept or run down at high speed enemy aircraft or cruise missiles. To show its wide range of speed requirements, a second Tomcat approaches low and to your left at more than 700 miles per hour. The slow F-14 is now demonstrating its ability to transition from the landing or takeoff configuration to the high-speed configuration. This vividly displays its capabilities to launch from the carrier and to intercept approaching enemy aircraft. As you watch the F-14 depart to your right, you will see a section of two A-7 Corsairs from the VA-81 Sunliners approaching low on the horizon. These aircraft are the first of several to demonstrate the carrier-based attack aircraft's ability to put weapons on target. The single-engine, single-seat Corsair is a pilot's aircraft. It carries a wide variety of ordnance and can deliver it with pinpoint accuracy. The two approaching A-7s are carrying five 500-pound bombs. Flying low, they penetrate enemy defenses. Once in the target area, they will pop up to 2,000 feet to acquire their target and to deliver their bombs. Offsetting toward the ship, the two A-7s locate their target, pull down to designate the target to their weapon system computer, and with precision, place their bombs on the smoke flares. The Corsairs will pull off to the left in a climbing turn to avoid enemy small arms fire. The next event will be a demonstration of the world's premier air superiority fighter, the U.S. Navy F-14 Tomcat. Designed for the role of fleet air defense, the Tomcat is the most capable fighter weapon system in existence today. Now approaching, the real star of the movie Top Gun, the F-14 Tomcat. The F-14 approaching is assigned to Fighter Squadron 74, the Bedevilers. Tomcats from VF-74 and from the Sluggers of VF-103 have been called on in the past to defend the Saratoga and her battle group from hostile aircraft, to protect Air Wing 17's other aircraft from attack and to provide reconnaissance photographs of important locations around the world. Their most famous mission, however, was the capture of the Achille Lauro hijackers in 1985. Approaching low and fast, another section of A-7 Corsairs will demonstrate weapons designed for supporting soldiers on the battlefield or for suppressing enemy defenses. Using the same delivery technique as the one previously demonstrated, two A-7s from Attack Squadron 83 will climb to an altitude of approximately 2,000 feet to acquire their target and deliver their 5-inch Zuni rockets. Inbound from the stern is an S-3 Viking from the VS-30 Diamond Cutters. The Vikings are highly versatile and maneuverable long-range jets, responsible for conducting anti-submarine mining up to 1,000 miles from the battle group. The Viking will demonstrate the S-3's high degree of maneuverability when operating at slow speeds over an enemy submarine, and its ability to track using a varied array of sensors. The S-3 has the smallest turning radius in the air wing. It can outturn everything except a helicopter. Sonobuoys may be dropped from the aircraft as underwater listening devices to detect the noise of a submarine. The MAD boom extending from the rear of the aircraft detects disturbances in the Earth's magnetic field caused by the submarine's steel hull. The S-3 is best used as a pouncer to conduct urgent attacks on a surfaced enemy with bombs, rockets, or torpedoes. A second Viking approaching at nearly 470 miles per hour demonstrates the S-3's dash capability to quickly reach distances of 200 to 300 miles from the carrier when required. Now making an approach is the far-ranging E-2 Hawkeye, or Hummer as it is affectionately known. The plane serves as the eyes and ears of the ship, functioning as a communications relay and airborne radar platform both on the surface and well above. Although these aircraft never engage the enemy directly, they make a significant contribution to the defense of our naval forces through control of fighter intercepts and in the performance of strike control missions at extended range from the carrier. Approaching from the bow of the ship, a daily occurrence during carrier operations, a KA-6D tanker from VA-85 refueling an EA-6 Prowler from VAQ-137. By refueling in this manner, fighter and attack aircraft are able to further extend their range mission by hundreds of miles. The three A-6 intruders now approaching possess an awesome weapons carrying capability of over 16,000 pounds of ordnance. The twin-engine Grumman A-6E intruder is the Navy's only all-weather attack aircraft. With a crew of two, the A-6E is equipped with a sophisticated weapons delivery system consisting of advanced radar, inertial navigation, and cockpit video display components. Each aircraft will release 10 Mark 82 inert high-drag bombs to demonstrate area coverage obtained during a night all-weather radar systems attack. From the left, two SH-3s approach. One has its magnetic anomaly detector, or MAD bird, streamed behind the aircraft and drops a smoke marker on its Madman submarine contact. The wingman breaks left and enters a hover. It lowers its dipping sonar into the water to track and classify the submarine. This allows the pilot to attack with simulated homing torpedoes. In the event of an aircraft malfunction or combat damage requiring that an aircrew abandon an aircraft, HS-3 would be called upon for the rescue. One SH-3 marks the survivor's position enters a rescue hover, and lowers the rescue swimmer into the water by hoist. The Hilo was protected from enemy fire by another SH-3, providing cover with its 30 caliber machine guns. What you have witnessed is teamwork. The successful completion of any mission requires the unselfish dedication of every individual on the Saratoga Air Wing 17 team. We conclude with the Diamond of Diamonds formation. A salute to you.